notice is that women are extremely, extremely they have the hunger. What they don't have is a support system who's pushing them forward. And the other thing is that they need the know-how, because seldom, you know, women have much more knowledge beyond their typical home or home life. So I think a lot of guidance is needed. You know, that kind of infrastructure, if we can provide, I think there's some very bright women out there who can come forward and really, really surprise a lot of us. So I think one is that we have used the lens of unstereotyping. We have looked at all roles as potential roles for women. The best way is to do it yourself. If you look at my career, I've been to Vietnam when I was pregnant, when I was going to have a baby. So I arrived in a certain job continued with a very young baby. But I basically took on roles. For example, I was the first sales director of my company, that was unstereotyping for me, and I used that to inspire other women and also made sure that I opened doors for other women on those roles which they had not done before, or even the company had not seen women do. I'm also the chairperson for OICCI, and we put together a white paper for the government based on 5-6 key things which are needed for women to join the workforce and also to stay in the workforce. Right. So I think today the world is changing. You know, we may be coming from we may have experienced our mothers staying at home and our fathers working, but even in my workplace, I see, and you know, we have a daycare, and I see at 5 o'clock men carrying those baby bags and their kids, because their wives are working, so they are collecting the kids. So it's changing very fast. So all our policies. And what millennials are telling us is that, listen, we don't want those fixed policies, because we are different, everybody's different and has different needs. So what we are building is flexibility. So I think in a company like ours, obviously not, and many companies like ours not, but I think there are many spaces as well where it happens in such a way that there's certain jobs which are seen as no-go zones for women, and those could be high-paid jobs, or those could be career roles, but because of those paradigms that they have in their mind, a woman can't do this role, it's unsafe for her, or she won't be able to do it, she's too fragile, or she's too emotional, it's too tough, it'll be stressful for her, or even simple thing like she's married. Oh yeah, but she's getting married, she's at that marriageable age. You know, in certain, so that I think is something that drives an unequal pay. When young management trainees come in, they're gung-ho about everything, very excited to prove themselves. So generally the thing is that, listen, you go into so many roles, you're going to be here for we want you here for the long run. Be patient, don't kill yourself trying to prove yourself, give it your best, and also be yourself.